Hi Curlies, welcome to my channel Curly Tales. I'm Talise, and today I'm going to be doing a wash and go using the new Mio Organics products from their MoistureRx collection. I'm going to be using the moisturizing styling gel, which looks like this. I'm going to be using the moisturizing hair butter, which looks like this. And I already applied the leave-in conditioner in the shower. So I got all of these products and their overnight conditioner from House of Beauty. All of them were $10.95 except for the gel, which was $8.95. And they were also having a 15% off sale for the 4th of July. Make sure you subscribe to my channel. Hit the red subscribe button right below this video. And if you are a natural hair channel, please comment down below if I haven't subscribed to you already, and I will subscribe. Okay, let's get into the video. Okay, so since I already applied the leave-in, now I'm going to section my hair into four sections, and I'm going to apply the butter and the gel at the same time. I love the smell in these products. They smell like kind of citrusy maybe, but they smell, they smell light and they smell so good, like clean, fresh. It's a great smell. So I'm starting with this section back here. I'm just gonna spray it with a little bit of warm water. Not too much, because I don't want my hair to be soaking wet. And I'm gonna start with about this much of the moisture butter. It feels so creamy and thick in my hands. It feels great. I already love the way it feels with the leave-in conditioner. It feels like it's just melting into my hair right now. Okay, that gave me a ton of definition. I'm just gonna add a little bit more, not too much. Now I'm gonna take my rat tail comb and just detangle this section fully. That's just gonna make it easier for me to distribute the gel and have less frizz. So I'm gonna start with about this much and just start in my roots, and then I'm gonna move that down. So I already like how this gel is feeling on my hair. It feels pretty thick and I love thick gel, so I already love this collection. I already knew I was gonna love it. That's why I was pretty much searching everywhere for it. It was sold out on her website. It sold out in like 30 minutes. So I didn't have a chance to get it off of there, but then I found out that it was on House of Beauty and I just swooped it up. I feel like I'm gonna get the best results with shingling, even though I really don't wanna shingle right now, but I'm gonna do it and it's just gonna be a quick one. If you don't know what shingling is, that's when you take small pieces of hair and you smooth them down. You can also curl the ends after you smooth it down. But I think I'm just gonna smooth today because I want it to go by pretty quickly. Okay, so that's what my hair is looking like after I shingled, super defined. Okay, I'm just gonna move on to the rest of my sections, doing the same thing. I'm gonna speed this up and I will be back when I'm done.
Thank you.
Okay, I finished adding the butter and the gel to my hair, and I'm loving the results. My hair has a ton of definition, definitely because I shingled, but these products, they gave me like basically frizz-free curls. This is what it's looking like from the back. So I'm gonna let my hair air dry overnight. I'm probably gonna put it in some plaits before I go to sleep. And then I'm gonna come back tomorrow once my hair is dry to show you what my results are looking like so I can tell you my thoughts about these three products. My hair is soft. It doesn't really have a crunch to it, but it's very defined. I like it a lot. I'm probably gonna stretch it tomorrow with my blow dryer. I'm gonna see if it can withstand some stretching without getting too frizzy. I'm probably about to band it up before I go to bed tonight. And I will be back tomorrow to show you guys what it's looking like once I stretch. This is my hair on day 4. And I gotta say, I am really enjoying this wash and go. It is not a like super defined, no frizz kind of wash and go, and that's okay. I feel like every wash and go doesn't have to be like that. It's soft and it's fluffy and it is really defined. I like it a lot. This is the back. I also realized I never read the instructions for any of these products, so I feel like I should do that right now. So the moisturizing hair butter says, apply hair butter to section damp or dry hair. Finger comb or comb through to evenly distribute product before braiding or twisting. Allow hair to air dry or sit under dryer. Perfect for twist outs, braid outs, and bantu knots. Style as desired. So the leave-in conditioner says, apply a generous amount to section hair. Work product through with your favorite detangling tool. Do not rinse, leave in. And the gel says, apply product to wet or dry hair and style as desired. Optional, for best results, apply Miel Mint Almond Oil while hair is still wet for added conditioning and to reduce potential flaking. Product might be very slippery during application. Allow hair to fully dry. So none of these products are really saying that they're for wash and goes, so I can feel like that's why this wash and go is so soft, but I am not mad at this wash and go. I actually really like it. I feel like out of the line so far, my favorite product has been the moisturizing overnight conditioner. If it's got slip, I'm gonna love it, and it has so much slip. I love it so much. But out of the stylers, so far, I'm gonna say my favorite has been the moisturizing butter. Just because when I put it on, this also had a lot of slip, and it just felt so good putting it on my hair. So I really liked it so far. I plan on trying to do a kind of slick ponytail or bun with this gel because I was on the Miel Organics founder's Instagram, and she had put her hair into a slick ponytail with it, and she said that it can be used for that. So I'm excited to try that and see how that works out. See how it compares to my wet line or my eco. I mean, I probably wouldn't use it all the time for slick back styles just because it's a small jar and it's not, like, it's cheaper to just use wet line, but I do want to see what it's working with. So I never really stretched my hair. I did put it in a stretching bun yesterday for about an hour. Other than that, I didn't do any stretching. So I think that's why it has a lot of the definition that it has, because it would have lost a lot of that if I used my blow dryer on it. All in all, I'd probably give this wash and go maybe an 8 out of 10. I'm here for it. I'm definitely here for the volume. I didn't really pick it. I kind of put my hands in and lifted the roots a little bit, but nothing more than that. Thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, please be sure to give it a thumbs up, subscribe, comment any videos you'd like to see, and share. Bye.